Welcome, everyone. My name is Konstantin, and I like to code. Video, which that you will see today, is kind of an experiment. I'm gonna do some live coding. So there is one podcast I was listening recently. It's called Odin Doma, or in English, Home Alone. This podcast is in Russian language, so I'm not sure how this is relevant to you, but what caught my eye recently when I was listening to this podcast is it has really good intro and outro music, which I'd like to collect somehow and listen this music alone. So here's the task. Oops. Okay. I'm gonna toggle floating notes. My task is to get intro and outro audio from podcast. And here's the URL of the particular episode. What we want is the podcast itself. Back. So, and again, ideally, I want to save all these tracks to Spotify playlist. So, every podcast, as you may know, is an RSS feed, which looks like this. Let's look at this in console. I did some preparation a few minutes before just to look into this. This is the XML file with some description of the podcast and the episodes. There is an item for each episode with description, which is HTML, and with iTunes summary in plain text, and also coded encoded, also HTML, but escaped HTML characters. The easiest thing would be is to parse them from iTunes summary, because it's a plain text, and I could do just some rugged extraction of all these tracks. And I'm going to use Chrome for that. Let's see. Oh, sorry, not Chrome. I'm going to use Go to do all of this stuff. First of all, let's create a new repo. Repo.new. And I will be an owner, the repo name, Odin Doma Music. Keep it private for now, license, MIT, why not? Gitignore, maybe you have something for Go, yeah, some default Go on Gitignore. Create the repo, and now it's empty. Okay, let's clone it. I use my own alias to boot projects where I want them to be, regardless from where I run this comment from. And I use VS Code to do all of the development. Let's zoom in a bit. With every project, I start with name.bin file, of course, typing all of things myself. Well, with some copilot help. Init Odin Doma Music ID. Odin Doma file, no dependencies. Of course not. should have a package client. All right, let's make one. Small app to parse RSS feed for coding DOM podcast and save tracks. Well, let's start with print out the tracks. And we will need to get the actual feed from there. So Eudora is this one. Still need log starting. I prefer to do this thing with the LAN just to track errors. Run. All right, let's try to run this small program. Good. Now we need to actually grab content. Now we need to actually grab content from this URL. To do that, we will use a standard HTTP client. So we will get bytes from this feed URL. If it fails, return the error, or rather wrap the error with some meaningful message. Don't forget to close the body, and I need to read the whole bytes array. So unless we can use decoder with decoder that reads reader byte array. Let's make sure that bytes are right first. So printf. Didn't get it yet, so this would actually be response. Here we go, follow the body. Now we need to parse this XML to decode it. First, let's make some podcast struct interface where we will parse it into. I'm not going to write it all, but I'm going to parse just the first few things. So XML channel, XML name, channel, probably title, no? I don't know, let's see. And the variable where we will read this into, and marshal the bytes we retrieve into this structure. Let's see. Will this work? Oops. All right. We parsed their XML. Originally, I was thinking about including some library to parse XML, to not write structure myself, but now it's kind of pretty simple, so I don't want to do this anymore. Let's just write ourselves for this thing. We need all the items. All we really need from the item is item summary. Don't talk about this anymore. Don't talk about this anymore. You don't have to write the color for this one. We'll make this unexported. Let's iterate over the items, printing just the summary. Something didn't work well. What is it? Item, channel, item, items, summary from the item. Let's see if any other fields are recorded at the item. Well, from the item I meant. Title from the item. No, I suspect the whole item array is empty. Yeah, something wrong with the struct. Channel has item, the item, and another. So what is wrong with this? I think I figured this one. Yay. What? All right. We got all the items. Now let's check the value. Not really. Is it iTunes summary? iTunes summary. Yeah. What about description? It is there, but not summary. Do I need to escape it somehow, maybe? Let's summon all iTunes. I don't know. Just trying something. Well, alright. Let's see how if somehow decoder go on. How to unmash your element with column. Yes, how to do this. Space? Space? No way. Well, yeah, some guys can be mine. Summary. Still empty. Not sure. ABC name, yes. Well, name field has an associated tag for the name or the namespace you have to give a name, an option in the namespace. Maybe. Yay. All right, we got all the summaries. Here we are. Next step is to parse intro and outro audios. Let's look at them. Intro of the podcast and outro. Let's go to regex 1.1 to make to test such regex. So imagine our text is like this, or whatever. I don't want to find numbers. Example of this. And is I want this to be multi-line, so multiple things per item. And if it matches, let's test only for first matching item. Don't want to look this. I'm not in the title of the summary. Let's just print the first summary that matches the regex. No, nice. String. Does Go support multi-line regex fetch? Seems like it does. Work. Yeah. All right. So we got the first match. Now we need to extract information from there. This is just the one, and we both. Which means we need something like fire strings and match all. You know, fire string all. If I just need all. All sub match. Okay, maybe. strings and match. Okay, intro, this track, outro, this track. Looks good. Now let's see for all of this, all of the episodes. Yay! It is working, but it's kind of a small list as well. Just 55, well, 50 or so. Well, I mean, maybe it's fine. Okay, this would be good enough already. Let's double check, maybe I missed some formatting. Oh, yeah, I need to be careful about this escape each down. I think this wasn't there in the list, yeah. This one is undetected. This one. No. Oh, because it says not the podcast but the episode. All right. Now the next one. 65. Okay, a bit more. Okay, before he also formatted differently. This is a bit more challenging because format isn't always the same. But we can try anyway. So it's either that regex or different control. Control. This one is something like I know. Episode. Let's ignore the first month now and print out only this previously formatted episode. All right. There is, I would say, some kind of pattern. Let's try. So I need something like everything that stops at word song or composition. Explanation. Song, composition, or track, or cover. So it could be song of some group. Oops, track meaning that. Same thing to the color. And ideally I need to extract the name of a song and the author, something like singer, group. Maybe not, maybe it's getting too complicated. Let's extract just this unhighlighted text for now. This one isn't matched. Looks good, but yeah, it might be not as easy to parse this out. Let's see. First, parse the regex. Maybe even like this. It would be just the last match. It is an invoice, right? Yes. Episode. Need to trim this a bit, or rather, I don't know, after space maybe. Where is that? Small bit. Oh yeah, there's space. Wow, well, not all of it. Yes. Mechanics. I'll do it right here. Yes, I can. I need to trim the dot there as well. Okay. Let's print all together. Oop. These spaces there exist there as well. Where's that? Space. Says not space. What is this? Long written space. Wow. Okay, is there a regex for my reference place? Oops. Now I didn't match anything. All right, I can trim it afterwards. See streams, trim left match three, and have this empty space, no breaking space. Yep. Okay. Now, author and then track name. Where here is track name and then author. Let's keep it like this for now. And we'll see, maybe we will use just Spotify API, and it will match the audio one. Now to print this all. Actually, that's yeah, just free all the choice. And save them into some file. Here we go. About 102 tracks. Exactly. 102 tracks. The next step is to actually use Spotify API and add them somehow to the playlist. This become part one. New main file. Let's actually copy most of the stuff here. It's gonna read tracks.txt and print it. This app is supposed to find tracks in Spotify. Find tracks listed in the file Spotify via API. Okay, file is there. Now let's see. Stripe it, Stripe, Spotify API. Never worked with that. Spotify for developers. Yay. Login into Spotify account. Create an app. Authorization. Get access token. Use the token in your API requests. You can follow. Get started. Okay. Tutorial, so it has Spotify account, I too. We will just scroll. Nice. So, skipped the dartboard. A few moments later, create an app. Import tracks. App searches tracks in Spotify. Not a name and adds them to specified playlist. Website should. Redirect URI. I'm pretty sure I'm going to use localhost for now. So Spotify. Settings. Client ID. And client secret. And don't worry, before publishing this video, I will rotate the secret, so don't even bother. And that's it. Let's see what else. Get the token with the secret, access token for 1 hour, I think. And then we can do things like this. And there's search API, search for an item, yay. Query, album, market. Okay, so first of all, this is the search API, and for playlist, I want to get playlist or maybe list them. Even when we create one, let's create one. Create playlist and add item to the playlist. List ID, position URI of the list of the tracks. All right. Seems to be more or less clear. One thing anyway I wanted to check is also API rate limits. Rate limits. Rolling for this window, all right. How many calls? Exceeds. Well, it doesn't tell you, maybe it's in the dashboard. Oh, maybe not. Quota extension request in the dashboard. No. All right, there is some API requestment. After all, I don't think that we will exceed this then. Well. First of all, secrets. Spotify client ID is this one. Spotify client secret. This one. Now I need to read this from environment variables. New dependency. The first one. Go get government vendor. ID. Now we have this dependency and this indirect dependency, which is fine. It's all downloaded here, which I will commit. Parse the environment variables. Now to configure Stripe API client. Is there any, not Stripe, is there any Spotify? Go. This should be from some guys in the wrapper. Cannot read this Go doc. Wrapper support installation. Okay. Out. Redirect URL. Redirect. Handler, client, authorization guide. Okay, and what can you do then? Add track to playlist, yes. Create playlist, maybe. Get playlist. Create playlist for user. All right. Attract playlist. Create search. Search query with options as well. What are the options? Limit number of items. Okay. And search result, we will get tracks. Full track with, I need ID. ID, simple track has an ID. Okay. I think, let's see, also Apache 2.0. Verification, copyright notice will be in the vendor. Oh, this one is MIT. Stars 1000, January 7th, last release. Which actions do we have? Go let in CI. Didn't update the actions yet, which isn't that much time left, I think, right? When they're duplicating this. Summer this year, we plan to migrate. Duplication process for September 27th. You don't have that much time. Have any PRs open? ID item. Well, okay. We'll maybe create an issue for this later. Meanwhile, all we need is just the code. So go get, oops, oh yeah. Oh, Protobuf, engine. Oh. This was this is hallucination. New client. Why do you require an engine and two versions of protobuf? Why? Let's see. Wait, now some other dependency you have reference part above them. I guess it's Google, it's this one. Well, of course. Where are your dependency? Well, the internal, and from there, there's protobuf because everyone needs protobuf. Okay. Okay. Token internal. HTTP transport. And here's our engine with URL fetch. Just out of curiosity, is there any other Go client for terminal? This is the terminal UI. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. All right. Which URL? Okay. Well, now what's next? So out, get your URL for out. And handle the redirect. authenticate. Not true. Ghost is an option. In the new. All right. What is the state? Unique state to identify session. Okay. Let's generate some random string. This is not random enough. Come on, random string system. Fine. Let's print this URL. All right. Read the environment variables and run this thing. So this is the URL we need to click open about treatment UI. View your Spotify data. I want more than just view. So with scopes. List of scopes. Scopes strings. Let's see the documentation on what scopes are there. Playlist, create private. Playlist, modify private. Files, search. No. This should be enough, I think. Use your activity to take action. Yes. And when I agree, it goes to local house, but nothing listens there. Let's fix that. I need to run the server, but stop it afterwards. Context, which one? It's critical of one. Ideally, I want to save this token for the next start. And this is starting to look pretty massive, so I want to extract this into a separate file in a few minutes. So once I have the token, I can just encode this JSON. This will save the token. Let's try. Well, I didn't start the server. Not get token. Why? Invalid client secret. Interesting. Oops, there's a typo, I think. Yeah. Now what? Say, oh, I didn't refresh the environment variables. Okay, now there should be a token there, yay. Let's see. Okay. The token is there. Let's say the purpose of this particular app is to grab the token. So this one is done. Spotify. Token oops, wait, what this is gonna cost. This one, yeah, so we have as well. Oh yeah. Move on the Spotify in the browser. Once we get the token, press exit 0 and something like. Token save to file. And this should be enough. Let's double check one more time. It's working. I'm gonna remove the token. And run this again. Refuse to connect. Save to file. Well, token is there. That's all that's relevant. In theory, I could tell to the user that all is good. Something like HTTP. Right header, it's a message, nice it. Login completed. Okay, let's try. Whatever. Doesn't really matter. This token is safe, so I'm gonna use this in the next app. So the actual purpose of this one is to grab token from Spotify API and save the file. New app. It's gonna be partly the same. Oops. This one is looking from file to Spotify client and handle tracks. No need for a directory anymore. We need some context background, and now I need to create file to find on it. How to do this again? OAuth new client. So we just clicked. All right. And we need to read the token from the file. If it was that easy. All right, clients should be created this way then. Let's actually extract this into something like create client. All I need is HTTP client to talk to Spotify. Wait a second, where are all these convenient methods that I could use in the client itself, like playlist, playlist tracks, get playlist from the client. Client is this one, not HTTP. Oh. Do I need to manually create one? What? Try. Now we're talking. Let's get current user. I am logged in. Yes. Okay, this is the final stretch, I guess. We need to open the file with the tracks, go over each track, then search the track. Let's start with that. I want to read file line by line. And yeah, this time we're not using configs or client, just reading the track line by line. Nice. Now I need to handle it. Handle it with the client. What does handle mean? Handle mean search for this track. I only need tracks. Oh, I'm building the town. Maybe. Let's handle just the first line first. Wait, stop. I did a break, I thought. Yeah. So in the tracks, the first line on underbelly. And here's a track. That kind of works. How about something like that? Too. Thing with the typo still works. The first item. What about this one? Two tracks, but I think the first one just would do. Let's see. Two tracks, one from okay, this is the first example of this not really working. And I think this is accepted. Not every track we will be able to find on Spotify. Although this one is there. How about I remove this thing? Okay, this one works. Okay, I'm gonna just go with what I have. I think it will work for most of the tracks. For this, where it will not, maybe I will add the wrong track into the playlist. So some manual check will be required afterwards. But first of all, we need to create a new playlist. Create playlist for my user. public. No description, not public. Not collaborative yet. I may change this manually later in Spotify. And I only need to run this once. So I will comment this out later. Playlist. Into one track. The first one is the only one we care about. If there is any error. Now to my Spotify playlists. I don't have this Audio Doma playlist yet. So this might be the time when it will create up. Wait, let me add some logging. What does it do? Creating playlist. Reading tracks long file. Searching for trap. Adding track to playlist. All right. I might hit rate limit, API rate limit error soon. We'll see how far it will go. Done. Let's see any new playlist they have. Okay. Looks like it created it twice. The first time I run this without logging, and the second time when I let it run till the end. So I'm going to delete this one. I haven't done this anyway. And here we go. This is the whole playlist with 102 tracks. I don't think, I have exactly 102 tracks, but maybe not all of them are the correct one. Let's check. I'm gonna go over this file. Actually, let me create a backup. And in the original file, I'm gonna go and remove what I think is a good match. So this one is definitely fine. Switch button. I think I wouldn't spend that much time for the last few minutes trying to find the track if I were more careful with regex expressions. I think I'm trimming too much somewhere maybe in here, some last character. Also, I could have removed text in between. Apparently that improved search results. And I also could have checked the returned Spotify track title against the line content, because sometimes they don't exactly match, or like if they different apart from each other for about 50%, then I could report this and not add track to the playlist. And that's about it. Thank you for watching. Let me know what you think about this experimental coding exercise. Feel free to share any ideas in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm not sure if I will do this one more time. Probably will. Thank you for watching. Bye.